Welcome to a cave scene tutorial for Blender. In this video you will learn how to sculpt natural shapes, how to paint textures using a mask, how to create grass and vines and distribute them using a particle system, and how to set up the lighting and compositing for a cave scene. Timestamps for each section of the video as well as a link for the Blender source file are in the description. Take your default cube and extrude it to create a very rough outline of your cave. You don't need any details at this step, simply create a low poly version of your cave. When you're done, switch to the sculpting workspace. If we were to start sculpting now, we would only affect the shape of the mesh we already have. We could add more subdivisions to be able to add more detail in the sculpt, but there's a much better way. In the top right corner, enable Dino Topo. This makes it possible to sculpt complex shapes out of a simple mesh by adding and removing details on the fly, rather than just adding details onto the base we already have. Using this tool, start sculpting the details of your cave as seen from the outside. To make the shape look natural, try to avoid very hard edges like the ones in your base mesh, but also don't make the shape too rounded. Looking at reference images of caves can be really helpful at this step. Now to the inside of your cave. When you start sculpting now, you will notice that controls are reversed. Sculpting with left click removes the mesh instead of adding onto it. This is because the normals of the mesh are pointing outwards. To fix this, go into edit mode, select all, press shift N and choose recalculate normals inside. Now you can sculpt normally on the inside of your cave. If you find it difficult to keep your viewport camera inside the cave and keep clipping out, press N, go to view and decrease the focal length of the camera. This will increase your field of view. Simply add more details, add cracks in the walls and ceiling, rocks sticking out from the wall, grooves where the water flows, etc. When you're done with the sculpt of your cave, add a plane to act as your water surface. Adjust its height depending on whether you're going for a small or big river or maybe even a lake. Now the walls of the cave look very cut off at the edge of the water, not natural at all. To recreate the effect of water flowing there for many thousands of years, add sediments and different layers of rocks. Add small rocks in the water and make the shape of the river more irregular. Again, looking at reference images can really help here. Now we want to texture the cave. Go into edit mode, select everything and press U Smart UV Project. Load in a rock texture and adjust the scale until it looks just right. Now load a mossy texture. Links to both the textures are in the description as well. Mix the moss texture with the rock texture using a mix shader node. To mix the two shaders, we're going to create an image mask. Add an image texture, disable alpha, give it a 2K texture by multiplying the current value by 2 and change the color to pure white. Plug the image texture into the factor of the mix shader. The mix shader will now convert the color of the image into numbers. White means 1 and therefore the rock texture, and black means 0 and therefore the moss texture. Now with that image selected, switch to the texture paint workspace. As you can see on the left, the whole image is white and the display texture is the rock texture. If you now press X to switch the two color slots and start painting with the black brush, you can see the moss texture to appear. Using this technique, you can paint the moss wherever you like. To make it look natural, paint it where the sunlight would reach it and where it's near water. Make it grow on and around rocks and cliffs and try to make the shape look realistic by giving it some irregularity. For the water, simply add a glass BSDF with the IOR set to 1.33 and a noise texture and a color ramp plugged into the roughness for some irregular spots on the water. Now the cave still looks very lifeless, so we're gonna need to create some vegetation. For the vines, add a leaf texture with alpha transparency. Add a cube and merge all the vertices at the center. Switch to vertex select and extrude the shape to get something looking like a vine. Add a subdivision surface modifier and apply it to give the shape more vertices. Then add a particle system set to hair. For the source, select vertices, render as object and select the leaf we just created. Enable advanced and check rotation. Set the orientation to object Z and have fun with the randomize value. Also adjust randomize face and scale randomness for more natural looking leaves. Using the base we just made, you can create several different versions for more variation. Then make the instances of the particle system real and join all the objects together again. Now we want to create some grass. Add a plane and add some edge cuts. Using proportional editing set to sharp, adjust the shape until it looks like a blade of grass. Then add two array modifiers to create a bunch of grass. Apply the modifiers in edit mode with everything selected, press P and separate by loose parts. Press F3 and search for randomized transform. Then adjust the values in the bottom left until the patch of grass looks more natural. You can then join the objects together again. With proportional editing, you can now adjust the general shape of the patch until you're satisfied. You can now make several variations as well. For texture, add a translucent BSDF with a noise modifier and a color ramp with green tones. Now back with the cave, add a particle system also set to hair, but this time render as collection, and select the collection with all the different variations of grass you just created. To control where the grass appears, now go into weight paint mode and start painting where you would like to have the grass. In the vertex group tab under density, select the group you just created by weight painting. Now the grass grows wherever you paint. For the vines, duplicate the particle system and make it a single user copy. Select the vines collection. Now the vines use the same weight paint as the grass. To create a unique weight paint for the vines, add a new vertex group and use it in the density tab for the vines particle system. Change the rotation, amount and scale until it looks right. Adjust the weight paint for both the grass and the vines until it looks good. Now place your camera. For a more immersive look, place the camera low, as if it was being held by a human on the ground. For a more distant look, place it high, as if it was being photographed by a drone. Switch to the cycles rendering engine and enable denoise for both the viewport and render. For darker scenes with fewer sunlight cycles, need more samples for the render to look good. I recommend a value of at least 80. For the sunlight, add an HDRI and adjust its rotation until the light falls into the cave just right. For more light control, add point lights in very dark spots. You can also give them a very subtle color change for more accentuation. Where there's dust or fog in the air, the sunlight reflects off of it and creates these god rays. To recreate them in Blender, we can add a cube where the sunlight shines into the cave and give it a volume scatter shader. A density of 1 won't let any light through, so we need a very low value. I used 0.015. This does increase render times, but makes the scene look much more realistic and beautiful. Now when you've rendered your image, go into the compositor, check use nodes and add a viewer node. Add a lens distortion node for some chromatic aberration. For the dispersion, I use the value of 0.02. Using an RGB curves node, you can make some adjustments to the brightness of the image. Finally, you can adjust the color using the color balance node. For a warmer and more welcoming image, make the image slightly yellow. For a more colder look, make it more blue. If you'd like to have the source file for the final result with all the textures, it's the first link in the description. If you've got any questions, feedback or requests for tutorials, feel free to let me know in the comments. That's it, thank you for your attention, I hope you learned something.